In this video, we're continuing on with the naming angles worksheet. This is a free worksheet provided by the CUDA software website, and I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this. For numbers 13 through 20, our directions are to name all the angles that have V as the vertex. So let's go ahead and locate V in number 13. V is this point here, and you can see that there's 1, 2, 3 angles that have vertex V. So the first angle will say angle JVI, which we can also just call angle 5. The next angle, angle IVH, we can just call angle 6. Because remember, there are different ways to name an angle, and you can name it whatever's easiest for you, but 5 and 6 are a lot shorter to write than JVI or IVH. Finally, we have the large angle, angle JBH. And this does not have a number associated with it, so we will have to write out angle JBH. Or if you wanted to, you could also name this angle HVJ, just as long as that vertex is in the middle. So three different angles share vertex V. Let's continue on to number 14. In number 14, we'll locate vertex V. Is very similar to number 13. We have angle DVE, which we can name angle 2. We have angle EVF, which we can name angle 3. And we also have a third angle, angle DVF, that we can name angle DVF or FVD. Three angles share vertex V in number 14. And number 15, here's vertex V. We have angle 1, angle 2, and angle TVR. TVR. In number 16, here's vertex V. Let's start with the larger angle, angle DVF. So we have angle DVF, we have angle 3, and we also have angle 4. Three different angles share vertex V. And remember, again, angle 3 or angle 4, you could also name DVE, or for 4, you could say EVF. Whatever method you're most comfortable with. 3 and 4 are just a lot shorter to write than DVE or EVF. Or EVD or FVE. In number 17, here's vertex V. We have our largest angle, angle KVM. We have angle 3, and we also have angle 4. And number 18, here is vertex V. We have angle 1, we have angle 2. We have angle 3, and we have a few more angles. We also have angle FVH, angle GVI, and angle FVI. And number 19, here's vertex V. I'm going to start with the smaller angles and work my way up. So I have angle 2, angle 3, and angle 4. I also have angle IVG. And angle HVF. And lastly, I have angle IVF. And you can see that I'm drawing small semicircles. These just help me keep track of what angles I've already labeled. They're not necessary, but they're helpful for me so that I don't accidentally repeat an angle. For example, when I'm writing IVG, if I see it another time as GVI and forget to double check that I'd already labeled it a different way, then I would have repeated the angle, which is unnecessary. Those semicircles or arcs help me keep track of the angles I've already labeled. Moving on to number 20, here is vertex V. This time I'll start with the largest. We have C, V, F. So angle C, V, F. Then I'll go ahead and label angle C, V, E. C, V, E. And then angle D, V, F. So you can see here's C, V, F. Here's C, V, E. Here is D, V, F. And then I have angle 3, angle 4, and angle 5. Six different angles for number 20. In numbers 21 through 26, I have to state if the given point is interior, exterior, or on the angle. In number 21, you can see this is my angle. Interior points would fall within the angle. Exterior points fall outside of the angle. P is among those exterior points or the outside points and therefore is exterior. In number 22, you can see that P lies on the inside of my angle. So P is an interior point. Number 23, P is on the outside of the angle and is therefore exterior. And number 24, P is actually on one of the rays. Therefore, it is on the angle. That is neither interior nor exterior. In number 25, P is interior. In number 26, P is outside of the angle and is therefore exterior. But just remember, inside, interior, outside of the angle, exterior. Number 27 and 28 are critical thinking questions. Number 27 says, to draw a diagram with an acute angle ABC and an obtuse angle DBE so that point D is in the interior of angle ABC. So an acute angle ABC. So now I have to draw an obtuse angle DBE so that D is in the interior of angle ABC. But note that both angles will have the same vertex B. So now drawing my obtuse angle, obtuse meaning greater than 90 degrees, D is interior, here is my B, and then E is my final point. So here's my diagram with an acute angle ABC and an obtuse angle DBE such that D is interior of ABC. Now in number 28, it says, in question number 27, why is it impossible for both point D and point E to be in the interior of angle ABC? Well, let's take a look back. If both D and E were in the interior, that would make DBE an acute angle and not an obtuse angle. So since ABC is smaller than DBE, it is impossible for both D and E to be in the interior. So since angle ABC is smaller than angle DBE, and we know this, since ABC is acute and angle DBE is obtuse, then it is impossible for both point D and point E of that obtuse angle to be in the interior of angle ABC. And this wraps up the naming angles worksheet. Please remember to subscribe to my channel and like this video if you found it helpful. Also, leave a comment below if you have any questions and to let me know which method for naming angles that you like the most. Using numbers or using the letters that represent the points.